ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಲ್ಲೇ ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತೇವೆ, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ನಾವು ಬರೆದದಕ್ಕೆ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಕಾರಣ ಏನಂದರೆ ಕನ್ನಡಿಗರು ಕನ್ನಡಿಗರಲ್ಲದವರು ಕಾರಂತರು ಏನೋ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ಅದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕೆಲಸ ಏನು ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಬರೆದರೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಆ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಜನ ಓದ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಅಭಿಮಾನದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಬರೆದದ್ದು. ರವಿಯವರು ಹೇಳಿದ ಹಾಗೆ ಚಿರಂಜೀವಿ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು 10 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ಚುಚ್ಚಿ ಚುಚ್ಚಿ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಬರೆಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡೆಡ್ ಅಸ್, ರಾಮ್ ಗುಹಾ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಕಾರನ್ಸ್ ಚಾಂಪಿಯನ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೈಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಬೆಂಗಾಲೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಟು ಟ್ಯಾಗೋರ್. ಸೊ today's program is very compact. We will start with a 7-minute video capturing the life of Shivaram Karant. This video is special because Shivaram Karant insisted with Chiranjeev Singh that only B.V. Karant should make the film, this documentary. So we took 7 minutes out of that. After that, Sugata Srinivasa Raju, who is both versatile journalist in English and Kannada, will speak about Karnataka and Karant's role in shaping Kannada and culture. That's a 15-minute talk, followed by Vivek Shanbhog himself, a very well-known Kannada writer, who's also a very dear family friend. He will speak about the book for 15 minutes. Both will speak in English, maybe mix a bit of Kannada. After that, we break up the session for a panel discussion, which Shobha will moderate, and some of us and the authors and Dr. Singh will participate. While that's running, we will run through some images from the book while the panel is being set up. So I won't come back up again here, but we are truly grateful in this awful weather and with all these problems with live streaming, so many have agreed to come. This is a very moving moment for all three of us. My sister Malvika, who is 8 years older than me, and Kshama, 2 years younger than me. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
ಹಿರಿಯರಾದ ಚಿರಂಜೀವ್ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅವರೇ, ಸುಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧ ಇತಿಹಾಸಜ್ಞರಾದ ರಾಮಚಂದ್ರ ಗುಹಾ ಅವರೇ, ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಯಂಗರ್ ಕ್ಷಮಾ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಅವರೇ, ಉಲ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಅವರೇ, ಮಾಳವಿಕಾ ಅವರೇ, ವಿವೇಕ್,
ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ನಾನು ಎರಡೂ ಭಾಷೆಯನ್ನು ಬೆರೆಸಿ ಮಾತನಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಎರಡನ್ನೂ ಬೆರೆಸಿ ಮಾತನಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. 15 ನಿಮಿಷ ನನಗೆ ಸಮಯಾವಕಾಶ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. 15 ನಿಮಿಷ ನಾನು ಮೀರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂದರೆ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿ. ಅನೇಕ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ನಾನು ಪಟ್ಟಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ 15 ನಿಮಿಷ ಮಾತನಾಡೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಭಾಳ ಕಷ್ಟದ ಕೆಲಸ. ಮೊದಲು ನಾನು ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕಂಗ್ರ್ಯಾಚ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ ಶಮಾ, ಉಲ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮಾಳ್ವಿಕಾ ಅವರನ್ನು ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಯರ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಯರ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಯರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಚಿರಂಜೀವಿ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅವರು ಮುನ್ನುಡಿ ಬರೀತಾ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅ ಹೋಮೇಜ್ ಟು ಶಿವರಾಮ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಬೈ ದ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಅಂತ. ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಹೆಜ್ಜೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಹೇಳೋದಾದರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದೇವ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಥೆರಪ್ಯೂಟಿಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಸೊ ನನಗೆ ಅದು ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ತು. ಅವರ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಯಾಕೆ ಬರೆದ್ರು, ಅದರ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಏನು, ಅದ್ರ ಹಿಂದೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನು, ಯಾವ ಥರದ ತುಮುಲ ಇತ್ತು ಅವ್ರ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ, ಅವರ ಡಿಲೆಮಾಸು ಅವರಿದು. ಸೊ ಅದೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಬಹಳ ಅಚ್ಚುಕಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಮೂಡಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಮತ್ತು ನಮಗೆ ಸಾಧಾರಣವಾಗಿ ಕಾರಂತರು, ಈಗ ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ಆಫೀಸ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬಸ್ ನಿಲ್ದಾಣಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿ, ಎನಿ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಯು ಸಿ ಕಾರಂತ್ಸ್ ಫೋಟೋಗ್ರಾಫ್. ಸೊ ಉಲ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅವರು ಪರಿಚಯ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಕಾರಂತ್ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಬಹಳ ದೊಡ್ಡ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಅಂತ ಮಾತಾಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಯಾವ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ದೊಡ್ಡ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಹೇಗಾದ್ರು ಅನ್ನೋದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಭಾರತದ ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಡಿ, ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಜನತೆ ಕೂಡ ಅದು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಈಗ ನಾವು ಈ ಬಯೋಗ್ರಫೀಸು, ಮೆಮ್ವಾರ್ಸು, ಆಟೋಬಯೋಗ್ರಫೀಸಿನ ಕಾಲ ಪರ್ವ ಈಗ ಶುರು ಆಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಹುಶಃ ಆ ಥರದ ಈ ಥರದ ಕೆಲಸ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಭಾವಿಸಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಾನು. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರಂತರ ಸ್ಟ್ರಗಲ್ಲು, ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸು, ಕಾಂಟ್ರಡಿಕ್ಷನ್ಸು, ಮತ್ತು ಅವರ ನೋವು, ಅವರ ಕ್ರೇಜಿನೆಸ್, ಶಾರದಾ ಪ್ರಸಾದ್ ಅವರ ಪುಸ್ತಕವನ್ನು ಅನುವಾದ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಕ್ರೇಜಿ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವರ ಕ್ರೇಜಿನೆಸ್ಸು ಮತ್ತು ಇದೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಅವರ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅವರ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಹಿಂದೆ ಇರುವಂಥದ್ದನ್ನು ಇದು ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಆದರೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ ಭಾಳ ಮುಖ್ಯ ವಿಚಾರ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗ್ಗೆಗಿಂತಲೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ಇದು ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾಲಂತ್ ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗೆಗಿನ ಪುಸ್ತಕ. ಶೀ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್, ಶೀ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಟಾಗನಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಶಿವರಾಮ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಶೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಮಚ್ ಎಸ್ ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಸೊ ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಅವರ ಪೇಯ್ನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಟ್ರಗಲ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪಾಯಿನೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬುಕ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಫೀಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್. ಯುನೋ ಮೀನ್ ನಾನು PDF ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓದಿದೆ, ನನಗೆ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಬಂದಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆ PDF ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓದಿದಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಅನಿಸಿದ್ದು ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ರಿಯಲ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪಾಯಿನೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ. ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವಿಚಾರ ಏನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ, ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕವನ್ನು ಚಿರಂಜೀವಿ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಾಹೇಬರು ನನಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ನನ್ನ ಹೆಂಡತಿಗೆ ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಒಪ್ಪಿಸಿದರು. ವಿ ವರ್ ಆಸ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನಲ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಅಸ್. ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಅಪಾಲಜೈಸ್, ವಿ ಕುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನಲ್ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್. ಬೈ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಬುಕ್, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅನ್ ಎಡಿಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಟೈಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೋಸಿ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆಂಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಅವರ್ ಡಾಟರ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದೇರ್ ವರ್ ಲಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ದೇರ್. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ರೆಟ್ರೋಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಫೀಲ್ ಇಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ವೇ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ಯು ನೋ ಬೀನ್ ಶೇಪ್ಡ್, ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಿ ವುಡ್ ಹವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಅ ಬುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡೀಪ್ಲಿ ಪರ್ಸ್ನಲ್ ಬುಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಿ ವುಡ್ ಹವ್ ಡನ್ ಜಸ್ಟಿಸ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಟ್ ದಿ ಮೆಮೊರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ 3 children ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಯರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್, ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ನನಗೆ ಕಂಡದ್ದು, ಪುಸ್ತಕದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಎರಡು ಮಾತು ಹೇಳಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ನಾನು 3 ಜನ ಮಕ್ಕಳು, ದ 3 children ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಡ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಸ್, ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೇಸಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಯರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಫಾದರ್, ಯು ನೋ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬುಕ್. ಜೀನಿಯಸ್, ದೆನ್ ದೇ ಸೇ ಕೊಲೋಸಲ್, ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಸ್ಪೀಡ್, ಆಂಗರ್, ಬ್ರಿಲಿಯನ್ಸ್, ಪೆರಿಪೆಟಿಕ್, ಸದಾ ಸುತ್ತುತ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು, ಇಂಪೇಷನ್ಸ್, ಇಡಿಯೋಸಿಂಕ್ರಿಸೀಸ್ ಇದ್ದಂಥ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಕಾರಣ. ತಂದೆಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡಬೇಕಾದಾಗ ಈ ಪದಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಂಥರ ಹರಿದು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಣ್ಮುಂದೆ. ಆದರೆ ತಾಯಿಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಬರೀಬೇಕಾದಾಗ empathy, love, pain, spirituality, integrity, and honesty, large-heartedness. ಇವೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಕೂಡ ತಾಯಿಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವರು ಬಳಸುವಂತಹ ಪದಗಳು, ಪದಪುಂಜಗಳು, ಅಡ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಸು, ಫ್ರೇಸಸ್ಸು. ಇದು ಸೊ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿಯರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಬರೆಯೋದು ಅಷ್ಟು ಸುಲಭದ ಕೆಲಸ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟಾಸ್ಕ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ದಿ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೆವರ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸೆಟಲ್ಡ್. ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಲೈಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ದಿ ತ್ರೀ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಅರೈವ್ ಅಟ್ ಅ ಕನ್ಸೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಯರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ರೇರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಆರ್ ಹೌಸ್ my mother is trying to settle the argument by writing a biography of my father now, and my brother and I are, you know, dreading as to what she is writing. So, you know, the arguments will never settle. Tira khasgiyagirtade tande ond mukha irtade horagin jagattige olagin jagattige innond mukha irtade tai bere tara kanista irtare. So idellavu ee pustakadalli bahala achukattagi nibhayisidare, adakke avarge matte congratulate martini. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೊಂದು ಪರಂಪರೆ, ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಪರಂಪರೆ ಇದೆ, ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪರಂಪರೆ ಅಲ್ಲ. ತಾರಿಣಿಯವರು ಕುವೆಂಪು ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಬರೆದ್ರು, ತೇಜಸ್ವಿಯವರು ಅಣ್ಣನ ನೆನಪು ಅಂತ ಬರೆದ್ರು, ಬಿ ಜಿ ಎಲ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಲೇಖನಗಳು ಬರೆದ್ರು ದೇವಿಜಿ ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗೆ ತೀನಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಈಚೆಗೆ ಅವರ ಮಗ ಒಂದು ಪುಸ್ತಕ, ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಬಂತು. ಸೊ ಆ ಪರಂಪರೆಗೆ ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಕೂಡ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಳ್ತು. ಟು ದಟ್ ಟ್ರೆಡಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ children writing on their parents, this book is a wonderful addition. And illi innondu nanage bahala sojigada vichara anta helidre, muru jana makkalu avara tandeyanna tata anta karitare. Namge nan maganige helta idde, avanu nagta idda. How can children call their parents grandfather anta? Their father is grandfather, not father but grandfather. But adre ಅವಾಗ ನಾನು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಇದು ನಿನಗೆ ವಿಚಿತ್ರವಾಗಿ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ, ಆದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಹಳೆ ಮೈಸೂರು ಕಡೆ ನಾವು ತಂದೆಯನ್ನು ಅಣ್ಣ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆಯನ್ನು ಅಣ್ಣಯ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಡರ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್. ಸೊ ಕಿನ್ಶಿಪ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಬೇರೆ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತಾರೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಕುವೆಂಪು ಅವರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವರ ಮಗ ಬರೆದ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಅಣ್ಣನ ನೆನಪು ಅನ್ನೋದು. ಅಣ್ಣ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ತಂದೆ ಅಂತ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಅನುವಾದ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋಲ್ಲ, ಆದ್ರೆ ತಂದೆ ಅಣ್ಣ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಎಲ್ಡರ್ ಬ್ರದರ್ ಅಂತ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಅದು ನನಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆದಂತ ವಿಚಾರ. ಅದು ಕಾರಂತರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನನಗೂ ಮೂರ್ನಾಲ್ಕು ಬಾರಿ ಭೇಟಿ ಮಾಡುವ ಒಂದು ಸಂದರ್ಭ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿತ್ತು. ಅದನ್ನ ಮೊದಲು ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕೋ ಕೊನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕೋ, ಸಮಯದ ಅಭಾವ ಇರೋದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಇಟ್ಕೋತೀನಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ನನಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಯನ್ನು ನನಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು, ದಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೈ ಡು ವಿ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಕಾರಂತ್, ಆರ್ ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕನ್ನಡ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ದಿ ಕನ್ನಡ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಕೋಟಾ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕೋಟಾ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ಕೋತಾ ಜಗತ್ತು ಅಂತಲೇ ಕರ್ಕೋತಾರೆ ಕಾರಂತ ಅದನ್ನು. ಅದು ಸೊ ಕನ್ನಡದ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಕಾರಂತರನ್ನ ಹೇಗೆ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅನ್ನೋದು. ಸೊ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆಯವರಿಗೆ ಕಾರಂತರನ್ನ ಮೆಚ್ಚಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಾರಣಗಳಿರ್ತವೆ. ಕಾರಂತರ ಕಾದಂಬರಿಗಳನ್ನ ಮಾತ್ರ ಓದಿ ಕಾರಂತರು ಬಹಳ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಟೆಲರ್ ಅಂತ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಮುಕ್ಕಾಲ್ವಾಸಿ ಜನ ಅವರನ್ನ ಮೆಚ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅವರ ಕಾದಂಬರಿಗಳಿಗಾಗಿ, ಅವರ ಕಥೆಗಳಿಗಾಗಿ. ಅವರ ವೈಜ್ಞಾನಿಕ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯ ಅಥವಾ ಅವರ ಎನ್ಸೈಕ್ಲೋಪೀಡಿಯಾ ಕೆಲಸ ಅಥವಾ ಲೆಕ್ಸಿಕೋಗ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ವರ್ಕು, ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ವಲಯ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಗುಂಪು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅವರ ವಿಚಾರವಾದವನ್ನ ಮೆಚ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂಥ ಗುಂಪು ಇನ್ನೂ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಬಳಗ. ಅದು ನನಗೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಕಾರಂತರು ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಕಾರಂತರು ನನ್ನ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ನನ್ನ ಜನಾಂಗದ ಅಂದರೆ ನನ್ನ ಜನರೇಷನ್ನಿನ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ವಿಶಿಷ್ಟವಾದ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂವನ್ನು ಇಂಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅವರು. ಅದು ಕಾರಂತರು ಮಾತ್ರ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಕಾರಂತರು ಒಬ್ಬರೇ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೂ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದೊಂದು ಒಂದು ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್, ಆಗ ಬರಿತಾ ಇದ್ದಂಥ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಿತಾ ಇದ್ದಂಥ ಕುವೆಂಪು ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಮಾಸ್ತಿ ಅವರಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಬೇಂದ್ರೆ ಅವರಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ಪಂಜೆ ಮಂಗೇಶ್ವರ ರಾಯರಾಗ್ಬೋದು. ಅವರು ಒಂದು ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂವನ್ನು ನನ್ನ ತಲೆಮಾರಿನ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿತ್ತಿದ್ರು ಅವರು. ಆ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಸಂಕುಚಿತವಾದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಆಗಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ನ್ಯಾರೋ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಲೂಸಿವ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂ. ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ವೈಬ್ರೆಂಟ್ expansive worldview that he implanted in the in our head, in the people of my generation or the children of my generation. And that we grew up with that. He tried to tell us from day one. Andre avarna odina mulaka avaru namage helidru ant helana avarna oduva mulaka namage tilidadde enu andre you don't have to think that just Kannada and Karnataka is your world. Idi jagattu ninna adombola. The whole world is your play field. That is the worldview that he implanted in our heads. And that is exactly what Kuvempu also did. ಓ ನನ್ನ ಚೇತನ ಆಗುನಿ ಅನಿಕೇತನ ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ವಾಟ್ ಡಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್? ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ಅನ್ಹೌಸ್ಡ್. ವಿ ಕೆ ಗೋಕಾಕ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಲಿಯಂಟ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಕ್ರಿಯೇ, ಐ ಮೀನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ವಿಶ್ವಮಾನವ ಸಂದೇಶ. ಸೊ ದೇ ವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಡೀಪ್ಲಿ ರೂಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್, ಡೀಪ್ಲಿ ರೂಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಬಟ್ ದೇ ವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ವರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು implant a dream in the younger generation to look at the world with a certain confidence. And that is what for me became very, very important. After Karanth, in fact, I had the great distinction or great honor of writing the front page obituary and the editorial when Karanth passed away in 1997. The only other time I got that opportunity in Deccan Herald was when Lankesh passed away. But I linked up the two. When I wrote about Lankesh, I said something about Karanth. And I said that Lankesh, who implanted a similar, who sort of continued that tradition of Karanth, I said he inherited the rationality of Shivram Karanth, social philosophy of Kuvempu, and the creative splash and femininity of Bendre. So that should tell you the kind of the previous generation to Lankesh, that is the Karanth's generation, the kind of work that they were doing and the kind of vision that they were trying to, you know, plant and implant in the heads of the younger generation. So speaking about this worldview, the Lankesh and Karanth for me are very, very personal and very important because they had similar candidness. And they had similar righteous anger, which was for me very, very relatable. And so I compared the two of them. But when we were growing up in our house, Karanth was presented to us by my father as some kind of a Bertrand Russell plus Albert Einstein plus Dickens, a bit of Tolstoy. You know, that was the kind of image he constructed for us. He said, you read him and you can engage with the world. That is the kind of thing that he used to tell us. So Karanth was this kind of Russell kind of figure for us. His rationality, his impatience, his constantly changing his positions, you know, when facts were presented to him. All of that was very, very interesting. And another thing which I noticed very early in Karanth is his language, that is, the language that he used for his fiction and the language that he used for his non-fiction were entirely different. Our non-fiction in a language ittala andre avara vaicharika barvanige bhashe ittala adike maatina rabasa ittu adike bala tikshnavagirudu andre he used to write his non-fiction essays like he spoke. So there used to be a great deal of, you know, I mean, there used to be a lot of punch and it used to be very direct and candid. So in Kannada, if I have to paraphrase that, I could say maatina rabasa avara non-fiction barvanigige ittadu adunna bala bega it made a lot of us relate to it very easily. Fiction took time. He was a very different Karanth when he wrote say Mukajiya Kanasugulu athwa are yavade kadambri niu tagobodu Chomanduri agbodu inna bere ond reflective character irta ittalli. ಸೊ ಈ ಎರಡು ಕಾರಂತರು ನಮಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಅದ್ಭುತ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಆಯಿತು. ಮತ್ತೆ ಆ ಕೊಲೋಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಆದದ್ದು ಹಾಗೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಕಾರಂತರು ಮತ್ತೆ ಕುವೆಂಪು ಅಥವಾ ಮಾಸ್ತಿ, ಈ ನಾನು ಹಿಂದೆ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂನ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ. ಈ ಕನ್ನಡ ದೇಶ, ಕನ್ನಡ ನೇಷನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. ದಿ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ವಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, decided to sort of, you know, create a certain kind. They borrowed heavily from the Enlightenment tradition. They borrowed heavily from the Romantics. But they blended it wonderfully, wonderfully with the local traditions, which is what is amazing about him. Anantamurthy avaru bere sandarbhadalli matnadta jeerna shakti anta helidru adanna. So yavudanna karantru matte kuvempu avaru torisikottru athwa ivarellaru kuda, if you look at bm Srikanthayya avara English geethegalu avellavu kuda English geethegalu, but kannadakke banda kannadadave agodu, kannadada prayer galagodu, adu kannadada ಪೂಜೆಯ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಳಸುವ ಪದಗಳಾಗೋದು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆ ಇವರು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡ್ರು, ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಂಡಿನ ಜೊತೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಬೆರೆಸಿದ್ರು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಆ ಜಗತ್ತು ಬೇರೆ ಈ ಜಗತ್ತು ಬೇರೆ ಅಂತ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಯಾಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ನಾವು ಇವತ್ತು ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟುಡೇ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನ್ಯಾರೋ. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಸೇ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕುವೆಂಪು ಅಂಡ್ ಮಾಸ್ತಿ ದಿ ಫೌಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಫಾದರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕನ್ನಡ ನೇಷನ್, ದ 56-50s ಅಂಡ್ 40s, 50s and 60s, because the idea of the linguistic state itself was very, I mean, as late as it arrived, at as late as the 19th century. It was not 20th century, you know, 19th and 20th century, in between somewhere there. So the whole idea sort of got picked up later, and they could have created an exclusive Kannada world. They could have imagined an exclusive Kannada nation. It's not that it was not happening. There were other streams too. People were creating other kind of Kannada nations. But these people who had so much of influence and learning and authority, they created a Kannada nation which was very wide, liberal, inclusive, not exclusive. And it is into that Kannada language and that Kannada nation that someone like a Chiranjeev Singh came into. If they had created a different kind of Kannada nation, I don't think Mr. Chiranjeev Singh would have given up his Punjabi citizenship and become a Kannada citizen. So aatharada vandu vishalavada vandu idanna karantru namage kattukottru, adakke navu avrige eshtu runiyagidru saldu. ಇವರೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಈ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಬರಹಗಾರರು, ಕುವೆಂಪು ಅವ್ರ, ಬೇಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರ, ಕಾರಂತ್ ಅವ್ರ, ಮಾಸ್ತಿ ಅವ್ರ, ಪಂಜೆ ಅವ್ರ, ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್. ದೇರ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಲುಕ್ ಅ ಬಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಸೌಂಡ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಮರಾನಿಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನ್ಯೂಯೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಕುವೆಂಪು ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ರಾಮಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಬೇಂದ್ರೆ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ Aurobindo. They sort of wove a different kind of universal and created different kinds of universals, and all of them were splendid. And one last point, I know I have to just wind up, and Karan's politics is something which we can have a long debate on some other time. His anti-congressism took very different shapes. I have lots of interesting things to say about that, but I'll stop. But the one notable thing is Karanth became disillusioned with the Congress at the same time that people like Periyar and others were also becoming disillusioned with the Congress. But what Periyar did with his anti-congressism and what Karanth did with his anti-congressism is completely different. And absolute last point, because the Renaissance and Tagore was mentioned, it's my personal feeling that they were two very distinct personalities. I don't think Karanth was not an institution builder in the sense that Tagore was. Karanth worked in isolation. But Karanth did not have the resources of a Tagore, but Karanth was not impoverished the way we would imagine people who worked for him were. You know, I mean, poverty or hana irlilla, anadhaarithiyal. He had enormous cultural capital. If you read this book, you'll realize the kind of patronage he received. Probably he was the only writer of his generation who received that kind of patronage from very various kinds of people. He traveled the world to write. And there were both traditions in Kannada. Some people traveled the world, and Kuvempu never left Mysore and Bangalore and Karnataka. But he wrote about the world as splendidly as Karanth. So there were different models in Kannada, and Karanth, he has made all of us what we are today. So I thank Ulas and Shama and Malvika for giving me this opportunity to speak here. I would have gone on and on, but I'll stop here. Thank you very much.
ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲು ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು ಅಪರೂಪದ ಪುಸ್ತಕವನ್ನು ಬರೆದು ಪ್ರಕಟಿಸಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಲವಿಕಾ ಅವರಿಗೆ, ಉಲ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಕ್ಷಮಾ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನನ್ನ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ಅಭಿನಂದನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಸಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇದು ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು, ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಸುಗತ ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಿದರು. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೋ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಬುಕ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಅಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುನೋ ಯುವರ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಆದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ಬ್ಲೆಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುನೋ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ವೆಲ್ ಡನ್. ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಶ್ಯೂರ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಪ್ರೂವ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್. ಆಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಆಲ್ ತ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ opinion stands, and they have argued with him, and you know, the book is full of such details. And I remember a letter which Karanth wrote to Masti. This was sometime in 1933. So Karanth ro Bengaluru ge bandidro Masti avarna nodlikke, and he goes back and then writes a letter to him. It reads like this. Nanna kritigalannu kondadidiri, ಆದರೆ ಅದು ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕಿಲ್ಲ. ಸಿಕ್ಕ ಕಾರಣ ತುಂಬ, ಈ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಒಂಥರ ನಿಷ್ಠುರವಾದ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಅವರು, ಒಂಥರ ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನೂ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳುವಂಥವ್ರು. ಆದರೆ ಅದು ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾನೆಷ್ಟಾದನೆಂದು ತಿಳಿಯುವ ಆತುರವಿಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ, ನಾನೇನಾಗಬೇಕು ಎಂದು ತಿಳಿಯುವ ಆಕಾಂಕ್ಷೆ. ನನ್ನ ಒಂದು ಬರಹದ ವಿಚಾರವಾಗಿಯೂ ನೀವು ತಪ್ಪನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸಿಕೊಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಗೆಳೆಯರು ತೋರಿಸದೇ ಹೋದರೆ ಇನ್ನಾರು ತೋರಿಸಬೇಕು. ಆ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮುಂದಾದರೂ ನಿರ್ದಾಕ್ಷಿಣ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕೆಂದು ಬೇಡುತ್ತೇನೆ. ರಫ್ಲಿ ಯುನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಯುನೋ ಯು ಪ್ರೇಸ್ ಮೈ ವರ್ಕ್ ಬಟ್ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಯುನೋ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಗರ್ ಟು ನೋ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಅಚೀವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್. ಯು ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಫ್ಲಾ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್. If friends do not do this, who will? This was Karanth. And I think all three of them have nirdakshinivagi adanna bardidare tumba preetinda ee pustakavanna bardidare. Amele iga Sugata helidage Karanthru, he shaped sensibilities of generations, not just you know our previous generation, ಅವರ ಜೊತೆಯವರಿಗೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್. ಅನಂತಮೂರ್ತಿ, ತೇಜಸ್ವಿ ಇನ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಎಸ್ಸೇಸ್ ಹೀ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹೀ ಫೀಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ದ ಗೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಕುವೆಂಪುಸ್ ಆರ್ಟ್, ಲೋಹಿಯಾಸ್ ಯುನೋ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, and then Karanth's world view and his way of how he has experimented with his life. So this is how Karanth was seen by the next generation, and even my generation, ig nanu athwa nanna nantaradavaru kuda igalu Karanthrinda andre Karanthrinda padiyod eshtu ide andre avara not just his novels but there is so much work that he has done in the area of for example in yakshagana dalli avaru maadida prayogagalu, yakshagana dalli avaru adanna yakshagana ballet anta avaru karadru, ee iritiya prayogagalu, amele avaru rangabhoomiyalli maadida prayogagalu, idellavu nanna talemarige maatra alla nanna mundina talemarivaru kuda tumba ondu prerananna odagisantaddu. Amele ನಾನು ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲು ನೋಡಿದ್ದು ನನ್ನ ನೆನಪಿದೆ. ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ 1977 ಇಲೆಕ್ಷನ್, ಅವರು ಪ್ರಚಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು. ನಾನು ಅವಾಗ ಸಿರ್ಸಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೈಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಇಟ್ ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ದಟ್ ಅದು ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ 10 o'clock, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೌ ಮೈಕನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. and it was 10 o'clock. And then there were thousands of people. And Karant, the mic ildane maatadidru. And avaru eshtu dhani ettirisi maatadidandre ashtu janaru ella avaru maatugalannu kelodakke ashtu kaaturaagidru. ಅದು ನನ್ನ ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲ ಕಾರಂತರನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ್ದು. ಅದಾದ ನಂತರ ನಾನು ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಸಲ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ. ಅದು ಕಾರಂತರ ವಿಶೇಷ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಯುನೋ ಇನ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ದಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಉಲ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅವರೊಂದು ಸಿಂಹದ ಹಾಗೆ ಮಲಗಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ. ನನಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಅವ್ರು ಸಿಂಹದ ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಅನಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಮುದಿ ಸಿಂಹದ ಹಾಗೆ ಅವ್ರು ಮಲಗಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ. ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕನ ನಾನು ಓದ್ತಾ ನನಗೆ ಇತ್ತೀಚೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಗಾರ್ಸಿಯಾ ಮಾರ್ಕೇಜ್ ಮಗ ಒಂದು ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅವ್ರ ತಂದೆ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಅದು ಕೂಡ ನನಗೆ ನೆನಪಾಯಿತು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಚ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಇದು ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅವ್ರ ನೆನಪುಗಳು ಮಾತ್ರ ಅಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಕಾರಂತ್, ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ವಿತ್ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕನ್ನಡ. ಸೊ ಅದು ಇಡೀ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡು ತುಂಬ ತುಂಬ ಸುಂದರವಾಗಿ ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡಿದೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ನಮಗೆ ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಅವರ ಹಿಂದಿರುವ ಪ್ರೇರಣೆ ಯಾವುದು, ಅವರು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋ ವಿಧಾನಗಳು ಯಾವುದು, ಇದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬ ಕುತೂಹಲ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಕುತೂಹಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಬರೀ ಅದೊಂದು ಕುತೂಹಲಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಕುತೂಹಲ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಯುನೋ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ವೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ವೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಗೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಔಟ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಸುಗತಾನು ಹೇಳಿದರು. ನನಗೂ ಆ ಥರ ತುಂಬ ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇದೆ, ಆದರೆ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಪಂಚ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇದೆ, ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಒಡನಾಡಿದ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇದೆ. ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ತುಂಬ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತರು ಬರೆದ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲವು ಸಣ್ಣ ಭಾಗಗಳನ್ನು ಅವರು ಹಾಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸೇಜಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಅವರು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರು ಕಾರಂತರು ಅವರು ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಟು ಟೀಚ್ ಯುನೋ ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ಮೇಟ್ಸ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ವಿಸಿಟ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಆರ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟೀಚರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ದೆಮ್ ಕ್ರಾಫ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆನಿ ಅದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಅವರು ಬೆರಳುಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಶಿ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲವ್. And it's such a beautiful thing. I want to read a few sentences from there. With his nimble fingers literally dancing, Karant wielded the scissors to cut out papers and foil, sticking them to create crowns, waistbands, armbands, and such other costumes. He was so fast and so deft. I was mesmerized by those artistic hands. In the past, I had argued as well as chatted with him happily, along with my friends, without feeling such an emotion. But this was a very decisive, strange moment in my life. Until then, I did not know what I really wanted to possess in my life. On that day, at that moment, I felt I had to possess those magical hands forever. A strong desire filled my heart to make those hands exclusively mine. Those magical hands began to haunt me day and night after that moment. This is such a beautiful passage in this. Amale Lila Karantra vandu hrudaya vaishalya avardu, there is something that was in her which is behind ee Karantra vandu world view ideyalla adakke adu tumba complimentary anta annanga anusutte. ಉದಾಹರಣೆಗೆ ಅವರು ಒಂದಿನ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಮಳೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಒಬ್ಬ ಮೀನು ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಏನೋ ಮೀನು ತಿನ್ನೋರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ, ಮೀನು ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗೋರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಡೆಯೋದು. ಅವರ ಕೊಡೆನ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಹಿಡಿತಾರೆ ಮೀನು ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗೋನಿಗೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಮನೆ ತನಕ ಮುಟ್ಟಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದೇ ಥರ ಇನ್ನು ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ಅದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಒಬ್ಬರು ಅಕ್ಕು ಅಂತ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮುದುಕಿ ಇರ್ತಾಳೆ, ಅವಳು ಎಷ್ಟೋ ದಿನ ಸ್ನಾನ ಮಾಡಿರಲ್ಲ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಲೀಲಾ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಏನು ನಿನ್ಗೆ ಸ್ನಾನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ವ ನೀನು, ಏನೋ ನನಗೆ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ನಾನು ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ. ನಾನು ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದು ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಸ್ನಾನ ಮಾಡಿಸಿ ಅವಳ ಕೂದಲಿನ ಸಿಕ್ಕಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಬಿಚ್ಚಿ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಏನೋ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮಾಲವಿಕಾ ಅವ್ರು ಬರೆದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಅಂದರೆ ಅವರ ಅಗೇನ್ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಸೈಡ್ ಅವರು ಇದು ಒಂದು ಕಾರಂತರ ಒಂದೊಂದು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿತ್ವಗಳನ್ನು ಇದು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅವರು ಜ್ವರ ಬಂದಾಗ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಪ್ರತಿದಿನ ಅವರು ಮಾಲವಿಕ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಪುತ್ತೂರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು, ಪುತ್ತೂರು ಪೇಟೆಗೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಒಂದಿನ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಜ್ವರ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಆವಾಗ ಅವರು ಮಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ನೀನು ಯು ಲೀಡ್ ಮೀ ಅಂತ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ದೇರ್, ದಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಟ್ ಡೇ ಆನ್ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಮಾಲವಿಕಾ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಲೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಶಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್. ಅದು ಯುನೋ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಚ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ದ ಯುನೋ ದೋಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ದ ಅದರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್, ಈಗ ನಾವು ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ಮೆನಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಡನ್, ಯಕ್ಷಗಾನ, ದಿಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಯು ನೋ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೀಸ್ ದೇರ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೋ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ನೋ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಇತಿಹಾಸಕ್ಕೆ, ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಇತಿಹಾಸಕ್ಕೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಗೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡನ್ ವಿತ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಯು ನೋ ಸಚ್ ಡಿಲಿಜೆನ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆ ಹೆಸರುಗಳು, ಆ ಜನರು, ಅವರು ಬರೋ ಒಂದು ಅವ್ರ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸು. ಯು ನೋ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಿ ವಿ ಹಾಸಿಗಾರ್, ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಯು ನೋ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಯಕ್ಷಗಾನ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ನೇಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಪ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಟು. ಬಟ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ ವಿಷಯ ಅಂದರೆ ಕಾರಂತರು ತುಂಬ ದೊಡ್ಡ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ, ಎಷ್ಟೆಷ್ಟೋ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಆದರೆ ಅವರ ನಿತ್ಯ ಜೀವನ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಆ ನಿತ್ಯ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಈ ಸಂಗತಿಗಳು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿಫಲಿಸಿದವು, ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಿಂದ ಅವು ದೇವರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸಮನ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಕಗ್ನೈಸಿಂಗ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ನೋ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಈಗ ಮೂರು ಜನ, ದ ಥ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್, ಯು ನೋ ದೇ ಸಿ ಹಿಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇ ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಥ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ನೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಚೀವ್ಡ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದರ್ ಓನ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟೀಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾರನ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಯು ನೋ ಇವ್ರು ಹೀಗೆ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವ್ರ ಕಾರಂತರ ಒಂದು ಕಾಣಿಕೆ ಏನು ಅನ್ನೋದಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನು ತುಂಬ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮವಾಗಿ ಸಟ್ಲಾಗಿ ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ಇನ್ನು ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ವೇರ್ ಕ್ಷಮಾ ಗೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ಅ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಟೂರ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆರ್ಕಿಟೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಟೂರ್ ವೇರ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅರ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಬಾದಾಮಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐಹೊಳೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಟ್ಟದಕಲ್ಲು, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಹೌಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಸ್ ಹರ್ ಹೌ ದೋಸ್ huts and houses are constructed, the material, and you can see his knowledge and his connection with Karnataka and various parts of Karnataka. Adu karantrige yavaglu ittu nanage ond nenpide, nanu ond sala avaru nodlikke hodaga avaru kaal baatittu and avaru adra bagge maatadlikke shuru maadidru, and from there on he moved on to Ayurveda, then about Ayurveda colleges, the syllabus in those colleges, and what is happening there, and from there he moved on to Yana and the fossil and so on. So he had this ability to connect things and you know present a larger picture because of his travels, because of his non-stop travels, and that you see in this book, you know, all through. You know, I think there is also a mention of his friends. ರಾಶಿ, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ರಾಶಿ ಅವ್ರ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಇವತ್ತು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ರಾಶಿ ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಕೆ ಕೆ ಹೆಬ್ಬಾರ್, ಟಿ ಎಮ್ ಎ ಪೈ, ಖುಷಿ ಹರಿದಾಸ್ ಭಟ್, ದರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಹೂ ಸಪೋರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕಾರಂತ್ ಇನ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ವೇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಅವರ ಕೆಲಸಗಳಿಗೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹಿಸ್ ಮೆಂಟರ್ಸ್, ದೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಕುದ್ಮೂಲ್ ರಂಗರಾವ್, ಕಾರ್ನಾಟ ಸದಾಶಿವರಾವ್. ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಅವರ ಚಿಂತನೆಯನ್ನು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಹನೀಯರು ರೂಪಿಸಿದರು ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಸ್ವಾರಸ್ಯಕರವಾಗಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇನ್ನು ಒಂದು ವಿಷಯ ಹೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಮುಗಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ಏನಂದರೆ, ನನಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ರೈಟರಾಗಿ ನನ್ನ ಕಾರಂತರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಈ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಓದಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಗ್ರೀಡಿ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ನೋ ಮೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಹೌ ವಾಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಶ್ಯೂರ್ ಯು ನೋ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ನೋ ಮೋರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ನಂಗೆ ನೆನಪಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅವರು ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಸಲ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಸಲ ಅವರು ಬೇರೆಯವರ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರೀತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಅವರ ಸ್ಮೃತಿ ಪಟಲದಿಂದ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಘಟನೆ ಇದೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಅವರು ಯಾರ್ದೋ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಕೂತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಇನ್ನೇನು ಬರೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಹೀಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಅ ನಾವೆಲ್ ಹಿ ಹಸ್ ಗಾನ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ವೀಕ್ ಯು ನೋ ಟು ಹಿಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋರ್ ಹೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರೂಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಟು ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಅ ನಾವೆಲ್ ಆ ಹೊತ್ತಿಗೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವಿಸಿಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಶಿವರಾಮ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬಂದೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್ ಫಾರ್ 10 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕರಂತ್ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ಐ ಕುಡ್ ನೆವರ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ನಾವೆಲ್ ದಟ್ ನಾವೆಲ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸಪಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ನೋ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿವ್ ರೈಟರ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹೌ ವಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಕಾರನ್ ಡಿಕ್ಟೇಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಫ್ ಥಾಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿ ಕುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ರೀಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಓನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಸೋ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಡಿಕ್ಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ I'm sure the you know children know more about it which I would have liked to have and which is why I said I became greedy after reading this book and there is something which I want to end this talk with reading the last passage from this book because I think this awareness and is there all through the book and all three of them have written it with this awareness These were all, and they write about, you know, this is the last passage of the book. This is just after he passed away. These were all stark reminders to us that as far as people were concerned, Kota Shivaram Karanth was their property. We had an obligation to share our Tata with all of them. However, growing up Karanth was a uniquely personal experience to each one of us. No one else could claim that rare privilege. I think this has, you know, is a wonderful way of ending this book. And I as I said, it's you know, this has been written with this knowledge, with this awareness that Karanth belonged to the people. Thank you very much.
As we set up the panel, I request the speakers and the panelists to come on stage to take a group photograph, please. Come, Chiranjeev, Sugata. Ram, you also come up. You inspired the book, yeah? Come. Shobha. Please come. Can you come to the center, please? Come in front of the chairs. In front.
So we've had so far a lovely talk by two erudite people about the book. You've all heard about the book. What is left for me to do is to draw out from the authors about the process of writing a book. And Ulla specifically asked me because I'm not a Kannadiga. And Solpa Kannada Kalita Idini. Adre I have been told to speak in English, so here we go. This is an extraordinary book because, like Ulla said, it is a book that not only gives a portrait of a man, a family, and each of them is extraordinary in their own way, but it's also a cultural patchwork that gives people who are non-Kannadiga and who are belong to the Kannada diaspora about a world that, as both Sugata ji has said and Vivek ji has said, we can see ourselves in this world and yet it eludes us in a way because it's very specific and yet universal. So with that, I would like to ask, maybe I start with Malvika ji. You know, one of the most poignant passages in the book for me was when your mother, I think you became a psychologist because of your mother. I would like you to talk about her in all her glory, in all her splendor, especially the passages where you, once she takes you to a well and you say, yeah, I don't want to die.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm happy to be here and especially talking about my mother. And she was 20 when I was born, so she was very young. By the time I was 20, she was already on to something which was not a sad story, because she was a very dynamic, vivacious, brilliant woman. And I would say she was, you know, all wisdom, all compassion, all laughter. That kind of person she was. And she took care of the whole world. And Karanth was her special need, that he should get the best in the world. So her support to him in the early stages, when he had, you know, he had no income, he had no job, he was an activist, a rebel, and nobody would have, and she comes from a wealthy family, but she chose to be with him and really support him and not really concerned about her own skills and abilities. And this was something that was amazing. And I find that a person who has so much in her should let it all go and take care of this man and bring him where he was. So by the time I was in my 20s, I found that she had a manic depressive illness. And it had started earlier on in a mild form, so nobody really knew, except I have described two or three situations when I had an inkling that she wasn't well. But around this time, we found that there were two difficult situations. One was her affective disorder, which is going into depression and mania. And these were devastating to my father because he couldn't handle it. He could never handle pain in anybody, and he couldn't handle her illness, in which she was very difficult to manage. And also I had an older brother who was out of control, very difficult to manage. He was, you know, we were having a lot of financial problems for him. In spite of his career going up and up, and he was doing very well, he had these two very, very difficult situations, which was long-standing. It was not an acute event occurring, but it was over the years. So these were his two hardest challenges, and I was in my 20s, and these two were really young children. So to me, I had to suddenly grow up, and that's what I did. In my 20s, I grew up very fast. I stopped.
You know, there's a lovely passage in the book where she presses her father's feet and he says it's like a breeze flowing over the roses. We have half an hour, so I had cleared it with them before because they have been unflinchingly honest. This is not a hagiography. This is a book that is both about the joy and the pain of growing up Karanth. We are going to dive in, because of the short span of time we have, into the pleasure and pain of growing up Karanth. So with that, Ullaz, I would like for you to talk about the approach that you took with being your father's son. There's a lot of anecdotes about you worrying about his anger. You spill the ink and then you run away and hide. About you forging your own path to become a wildlife biologist. And then the difficult passage at the end of the book about M. Perhaps you can talk about writing it. How did you choose? Why did you choose to write all of that?
There are two or three things that I picked up from him. One was that you stand for what you believe, and you are very clear, very explicit about it. So, you know, a lot of stuff in that book that we have written is we had to say these things because he would have. But at the same time, I question myself, if he was still alive, would we have written it? I don't know. We would have worried about hurting him. So it's in some sense, it's written a long time after. So it's easier to be judgmental, so to say.
Not judgmental, forthright, yeah. I think.
The other thing with him, for me, in writing the book was, for me, you know, having read good biographies like Ram's very relevant. See, you bring the social context into it. It's not just about and our dad and how cute he was or how cute we were. It is about the context in which he grew up. And he had talked a lot to me, and I used to probe him about his politics. Not so much about the family issues. It's about his politics, ideology, his interest in nature, the mistakes he was making identifying animals. So I had that kind of a relationship with him. And I also realized the kind of people who had shaped his mind. For him to be born in such a conservative community at a time in 1902, and by 1920 to throw away his sacred thread, join Gandhiji, get disgusted with Gandhiji within 15 years because he couldn't solve any real world problems, then forging his own path in different ways. So all this really I shared with him in real time, although I was a little kid, his election campaigns, his politics. So to me, bringing that context to the book was very important. Rather, the core of it was us and him and Amma and what we went through. But to me, the joy of writing this book, it started as a pain. It became a joy as I started researching what was needed to bring the context. For example, he was incredibly shaped by the Chitrapur Saraswat community, whether it was Karnad Sadashivrao or Mulali Shivrao or the Gulwadi Venkatrao, who set the frame for modern Kannada literature. He was shaped by Chitrapur Saraswats more than by Kota Brahmins or whatever.
Yes,
so, researching that, I had to read Frank Conlon's monograph on Chitrapur Sar. I had a lot of friends are there, but, you know, to dig in. Similarly, you know, there's this whole impression that Shivaram Karanth was a Brahmin, that bore the car. But Amma was a Bunt, and I had to bring that in. My grandfather was the first Bunt to go abroad, first person in after World War II to start a medical equipment company, started as a migrant in Bombay and became the treasurer of the first Bombay Bunt Association in 1920. To me, all this was important. So for me, trawling through all this stuff and assembling the context for the story we were telling, that really made up for all the pain of finding somebody's date of birth and, you know, all that stuff which makes history real.
Shamanji, you know, there's this great line in The Lion King that we see him in you and we see him in each of you. You write about the his art, his Yakshagana and everything. How was your approach? Because clearly his aesthetics influenced you. And what did you take out of your dad and your mother? And what was your approach to writing the chapters you did? It's on.
I admired greatly his aesthetic sense. He had great aesthetic sense of color, sense of form. And he was not very fond of classical dance. So I initially took part in his dance drama, which he directed in the World High School. And very soon he realized that certain discipline of the body and the mind.
Keep it closed.
It was very impressive. But I felt that certain discipline was required. So I told him that I would like to learn Bharatanatyam. He said, okay, go ahead. Whatever the path you choose, be sincere. And learn to dream big. And don't be after money, name, and fame. You chase your dreams. This is a big lesson which I learned. So this has been a guiding spirit all my life. And I have great aesthetic sense. So I have been associated, I mean, since we had the ringside view of this experiment on Yakshagana, and the change which he brought then within the tradition, one is to the Bhagavata would sing a certain text. And it will be repeated as a dialogue, the same songs, same lines, as a dialogue, which he deleted, much to the charging of the traditionalists. And also certain discrepancies in the costume and the other things, which the especially female characters, people were wearing nylon sarees and plastic flowers. So what he brought in was a very... designed a traditional smaller headgear for the female character, and the original color combination of orange, black, and red were really gelling together. And he had a theory that when a baby expresses its feeling, it uses the entire body. Entire body, the hands, body, facial muscles, it expresses through the whole body. As you grow older, the social conditioning sort of restricts your movement and expression. We don't express through the whole body, facial muscles, and use all our limbs. This is something which he adapted. He has not actually learned to Yakshagana dance itself, but he has researched the great or northern style of Yakshagana called Bharatiya Yakshagana. He brought about certain changes and refined the costumes and headgears, and his theory of using the whole body, facial muscles and eyes, and emote through the body as a whole. This is what he adapted to his Yakshagana ballet, which was initially criticized very much, but as there was no dialogue, it became from South America to Japan. It has won a lot of appreciation because there were no conversations. It was all sung and expressed through the body. This is there are some artists who work with him. One of his very brilliant students, Sanjeeva Suvarna, is still a yogi, and he used to understand all the nuances of what he taught. He would say that when my father was teaching, he would learn everybody's
parts,
actions, and characters.
You
and
have a.
When your father was forgot, he would
write it down.
And help him. He's a very, very great, very humble artist. He has not been to the school beyond the first standard. But today, he has traveled 52 countries, and there is an ace subject an artist. And he's carrying forward this artistic legacy of my father. In the field of Yakshagana, I understood my father's vision. And these are visionaries. I can compare only with the Rukmini Devi Arunay and Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra. We have sometimes they have to break the tradition, innovate, bring in new energies and artistic ideas and aesthetic concepts. Otherwise, my father was a lone traveler in his film. He always rode along the untrodden path. He said, Nanyaude Guru Siddhanta Vrata Opi Purudhila.
And there's a section where you say he emotes so well. Where do you think that comes from if he's not trained? How does all that emotion come?
As soon as he listens to the music, he would start dancing. His own dance. Not Yakshagana.
But his own.
And not actually Yakshagana's steps, but he could emote through the whole body.
Yeah.
For this, he has worked a lot on this. Especially certain choreographic marvels, certain scenes, I still remember. One is that of Abhimanyu dying in
Chakravyuha.
Here, Bhagavatas not only put sing very loudly, six warriors surround a young boy and kill him in the battle. It is a very moving scene where everyone would shed tears. Shadunakar Vondagi Kondevaha Sudayan. And the Bhagavata would be shouting and said, no, this is a scene which is so poignant and sorrowful. You don't shout. It was done in a very low tone to create that
mood
of sadness and that tragedy.
Thank you.
This is a point. And it became such a hit, you know, because there are the Yakshagana artists who we would, they are shown. Here the Abhimanyu dies in a battle fighting six warriors. And the Kaurava warriors rejoice. This is how it is also shown in some ways. But my father said no. After they kill this boy, all of them, they hang their heads in shame and slowly walk around the body. Shadugataru Vanda Kolde Pahasure. This is one of the most moving choreographic scenes I have ever seen. Also, Nala is bitten by the Karkotaka snake. Although this Karkotaka is never shown, but he tries to save it from the fire and it wraps around him and bites him and he turns into a very deformed dark man called Bahuka. Then he asked the snake, I only tried to save your life. Why did you do this to me? Then he says, during your Ajnata Vasa, this deformed form will help you. These are some of the marvelous choreographic pieces I have ever seen in comparison with any of the internationally best produced scenes I have seen.
But let's go back to the writing of the book, which I would like to talk to all of you about. Maybe I have asked Dr. Singh a question and then we come back to the actual process of writing the book, if you don't mind. Why were you after them to write this book? I loved your foreword, by the way, and... maybe in the bottom here.
Yeah. Well, thank you. You see, his public persona was so forbidding, and at home he was so affectionate that I thought the private Karant also needed to be brought before the public. You know, I attended many official meetings with him because at my request, he accepted whatever I told him to become a part of. So when you saw him in those official meetings sitting there, he looked like a figure carved out of granite. You know, so forbidding was the public persona. The private persona was very different. And I don't know, I mean, this is one of those inexplicable things that I was fortunate to have so much of his affection. And I have seen him with children also, his granddaughter, Ulad's daughter, and other children. And he was so tender with children that the forbidding granite-like persona was also very tender, which comes out in this book. So I'm very happy the way the book has shaped up. And also another thing, you see, he was a very humorous person. And that humor is there. It was a dry kind of humor, you know, what you would say, probably English kind of humor.
A punster.
I've given one example here. My friend, Professor Nagbhushan, Teenam Shri's son, mentioned once Karanji was visiting their house. So he took out one of his books and asked for his autograph. He took out his pen, and the pen didn't write. And Teenam Shri said, oh, it has gone dry. So he just said, ullu khali aage. That sort of thing. Also, when Nagbhushan was in England, Karanji came there with his Yakshagana troupe. And they were both there in the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. And they saw the news item that some organization had conferred the award of Vishwamanava on Kuvempu. And he laughed. He said, this is interesting. One who never left his house is now honored as Vishwamanava. You know, that's the sort of humor he had. And that comes through in his novel. Yeah. So I think it is in Marali Manige, yeah, where the maidservant is exasperated with the Brahmin master, and she says, Abba, Ibrambro, you know, that kind of thing. So all this needed to be brought also out. Now, his autobiography is as translated by Sharda Prasad, the 10 faces of a crazy mind. Now, this is the 11th face which has now been brought out.
Yes. So we have 15 minutes, and I, much as I, it's sort of a stunt, but let's do it anyway because we want to cover a lot of ground. What was the hard, in three or words or sentences, what was the hardest thing about writing this book?
I think I have inherited Karan's ease of writing. I have no issues. You ask me to write, I'll write anything.
So it was not hard at all?
Not hard at all.
So for Ullas, challenge of being Shivram Karan's son, and what did you learn from it in a few words or sentences?
He inspired me. And then I decided I have to stay as far away from him as possible, build my own career without ever using him for anything, stand on my own feet so that he respects me. He kind of charged me out like a toy mouse and let me loose. After that, I didn't go back to him in some sense. So writing the book to bring that part out, how my natural history, how it was triggered, because he and I were, some people are hardwired to love animals. Love in the sense, not go and hug a tiger. In a sense that you want to watch animals. He had it. One of my uncles had it. I have it. So that's what wrote me. And while we are at it, since we are running very short, this is a current event. There's another contributor to the book here, And in the audience, we have two people. One is Karan's granddaughter. The other one is Karan's great-granddaughter. I would just like them to just stand up and say hi and sit down. I would the granddaughter is Swapna Sabnis, Malaka's daughter. And the great-granddaughter is Kea, who's my granddaughter.
I will come to Shamaji, but this is as much about your mother. So everybody has used empathy about her. So three qualities about her that you come to mind. This is free association, which is your field and sort of mine. Yeah.
I would say laughter, wisdom, and compassion. That's her put together.
Okay. And three qualities about your father, Ullas, that that riled you up. You said he made you a mouse.
I think one of the things was, unfortunately, I have the same gene. See, he was not a reasoned debater. Lung power always kind of tended to win the argument, which as a scientist, I don't not a good model to follow. So that riled me up. And he also was a very poor judge of people at some times. If you, you know, because of this dominant personality, when he sparked, people didn't engage with him at all. So he ended up collecting a lot of mediocre people who flattered him all the time. And that's nice, but still, you know, that's something I didn't like. I like to have people who argue with me.
Shamaji, about your mom, Leela Karan, what did you learn from her in three sentences or words? Only because we are running out of time. And I have one question for Dr.
Three sentences.
I wish we could talk for an hour.
She has really a sympathy for human beings, the compassion, and poor people would gather around her and cry and discuss their problems, and she was always there to help them. This is something which was very, as I grew up, and studied there, not at the time.
Do you think she resented your father because she was also so talented?
No, surprisingly, no. She always took great pleasure in his achievement. To a point, she was also very talented, but never bothered to cultivate it or go ahead in life with him. She was a very good singer, dancer, and very good actress. But she never bothered about her own talent.
My sympathies are with the children. It won't have been easy growing up under his shadow. Even Ratindranath had to run away from Shantiniketan. So Karan ran away. That's not surprising.
Yes.
I would like to answer that, because many people ask me, living under the banyan, shadow of the banyan tree, how do you people, you know, how did you come up? But I always told he was not a banyan tree which did not allow anything to grow under it. He was a Kalpavruksha. That he always allowed us to be what we are. So I may disagree on this with my own brother, but I think we did not feel he was a person who we have to obey. We cannot argue, or, you know, we can't fight. We did that all the time, criticized him and always made fun of him for his poor quality jokes. So we were very free. We never kept him on his pedestal. We always teased him, made fun of him, made fool of him. All that we did. We couldn't have done it if he was such a formidable, authoritative person.
No, Malaka. Malaka, that calls for another book in which all this that you're mentioning now should come.
But Dr. Singh, the question to you is this genius and prickliness that we see in the book, place it in context with the other people you have mentioned. Were they also like that?
You see, as Ullas has written about his friendships, etc. I mean, I have mentioned in the foreword,
yes.
I saw him with K.K. Hebbar on many occasions. I invited them both to Mysore and made them plant the trees which I've written about. Now, interestingly, like Tagore, when he started painting, it was K.K. Hebbar who dissuaded him from painting and drawing. He said, why do you do this when I can do it for you? But I wish he had encouraged him, because I would have loved to see his paintings also, apart from anything else. Now, you see, you have here, when the documentary was shown by B.V. Karan, a clip of his dancing. There is a painting by Avanindranath Tagore of Rabindranath Tagore dancing as a bowl. It's a very famous painting of Avanindranath Tagore. So those kind of similarities, which I found fascinating, and that's why I said the only person you can compare him with is Tagore. Though Sugata says that they are very different persons. Of course, they are very different persons. But their universe was different, as Karanth mentioned. Each had his own universe, his own this thing. And
was his creativity driven? Was it effortless, or did he have demons that sort of charged him up, like he said, the mouse? When you met Dr. Karanth, where did that come from?
You see, when I was with him, we seldom talked of literature or the way he wrote. Everything else under the sun was discussed. Mm. Especially about the destruction of temple sculpture in Karnataka, about Pattadakal, Badami, etc. His appreciation of modern art, those kind of things. He never discussed about his own writing. I don't ever remember when he mentioned any of his own novels or any of his other works.
Yeah, you know, this whole business of writing, he would observe very acutely. It'll all sit somewhere. He would be thinking about it for a whole year. Then for 8 to 10 days, he'll crank out that novel. Mm. So there wasn't any pain effortless. Coming out.
Yeah.
But when he did his popular science, it was different. He would have files, he would have tagged things, he would have albums, pictures, assembling it. His non-fiction was real pain, particularly the science, because he was only a matriculate and he's trying to understand theory of relativity and everything. Mm. So that was a painful creative phase. But the novels just came in those 10 days.
We have 5 minutes. So how did you all three write the book? Did you sit together? The process?
Separately.
Yes, yes, yes. I mean, did you meet once a week?
No, we had no schedule like that.
Mm.
We met whenever one was free.
Mm.
And, you know, we would write. More or less, the first text was written on our own.
Mm.
Like mine was called Bonding with Karanth, etc. And then we found there was a lot of overlap. Then we got together and said, no, this has to go somewhere else. This has to go somewhere else. So pruned it a lot because sometimes we had different versions for the same event that we had to sort out a lot.
Did the son-in-laws and the daughter-in-laws have a say in the matter of the book?
No, it was so long drawn.
Yeah.
Everybody had lost interest in it.
Ullas, what about you?
Oh, we started, about 10 years ago. So it took a long time. And it's gone through various versions, like part of what she says is true, part of it was different. It was like assembling this gigantic machine, then whether it will start, whether it will move. It's only in the last 3 months, because she was nagging me like hell for the 8 of the 10 years or 9 of the 10 years. Then in the last 1 year, I was like a fiend trying to complete it and saying, do this, do that, lecturing her, calling and harassing her, etc. We managed to get it in time.
Your version of how you wrote the book, Shamaji?
Well, if you ask us to write, I mean, I initially wrote the book, and then Karanth because he had already dropped out from the Manasinathamudagalu. And then again, Ali Dudi is an anathin on the Manasinathamudagalu. Then Suriti Kattavati is the worst in my to write it also. And he does speak into our own inner self and nothing. Lots of things change. It has been a very rewarding as well as frustrating, painful also at times. And we are happy we have done it. And I just want to mention his Gita Nataka, Mr. Vivek Shango just missed it out. And I remember a very sad story of a Dalit girl called Somi. Somi Asobhagya it is called. And I think it's not out of place. I remember that. Just a line or two of this Somi Asobhagya, which he himself used to sing when some friends visited. Are you supposed to say? I hope it's not.
Please do.
Kadige pannada urugi avalu, kadina bari alli beledu bannavalu, kusalu guru ange obbale magalu, tumbiya kanni.
It's a very tragic story. Very tragic story.
And he used to sing it, and also another play called Yaro on the Rain.
Thank you.
Which has not been given sufficient attention is his scientific writing. He really expanded the possibilities of the language. I think no one has written as much about science in Kannada as he has. And fashioning the technical vocabulary for that is his great service to Kannada. And
that was going to be my question to you is, what do you wish the next book will write? I mean, what is left? The science is a good start.
Of course, that's not a part of this book in
yes,
the sense
yes.
that this is the children's
correct.
Homage
so it was a different
to their
book.
Father. But I'm saying, in general, his contribution to Karnataka and culture and literature, all that, besides his contribution to expanding the possibilities of the language.
Yeah.
That is equally important.
The last thing I want to ask each of you, the same question, in a minute, only because we don't have time. Talk about your parents' marriage. Was it what did you think of your parents' marriage?
I thought she described it the best, and Vivek read the bit. She was, most romantic human being ever. And whatever she has to say, it is there in the book, and you will see her, what she was.
I would say the first 25 years were really the creative energy. His creative energy was there, and my mother was standing behind him. They had the greatest financial difficulties. It was a period of turmoil and creativity. The second half, her health fell apart. And apart from that, I don't agree with Shama at all. I think at that point, she started deeply resenting how much she had forgone to support him, and she felt neglected by him. So that second half was a sad part, because he became very famous, he flourished, whereas she really had not only mental health, in other ways also kind of felt cheated out of her share, so to say. So there were two parts. One which we kind of grew up in, the other one we kind of were a part of and had to manage in some sense.
And how did your father rationalize that? He
just did what he wanted. He wasn't a great rationalizer of why he was doing something. And that's why he accomplished so much.
And what do you think of your parents' marriage? Or how did it appear to you?
It was very good, and what is great about it was he was not a famous person or a wealthy person when she married him, and she had gone through a lot of difficulties in the initial stages. Later, both her mind and body gave way, your mental and physical health is deteriorated. He did take care of her. I mean, that's one of the reasons also why he shifted to Saligrama, which is very close to Manipur.
I'll leave you with the benediction.
I'm glad that finally the book has come out, and it has come out so beautifully.
Thank you all. I think we have time for 3 questions. We'll run a little bit over if that's okay, or we stop now. Yeah. Any questions for the authors from the audience? Anyone from the front while here, you have to come.
I think the question is, Karan, at a very young age, started all these experiments, and there's a certain sense of fearlessness, and especially the way he wrote to Mass Theatre at such a young age, and the various experiments he did, and he went on experimenting. It would be only possible by a man who had tremendous self-belief and self-confidence. But when we look at his adolescence, his academics were weak, he was a dropout. Never made money during his initial stage, I think, did not have a proper job.
What's the question?
So the question was, where did he get that self-belief or self-confidence from? Because it doesn't really,
I think there was no shortage of self-confidence at all. He was in the high school, when he was in Kundapur High School, those days, I'm talking of 1907, 1908, he was a little boy. There was a rule that you should speak only English. And do not speak Kannada, the headmaster, masters, those days, so that you groom the people to run the country. So he made a joke telling his friend in English loudly, don't laugh in Kannada, you ass, laugh in English. He was bold. Yeah. There was no question of diffidence and all this. He was like a bulldozer and a bulldog.
Any other questions from the audience? I mean, you have 3 distinguished authors here. 3. Thank you all for your patience and for your presence.
Thank you, Shobha.